guys, big news already on a Monday out of Hendrick Motorsports. A crew chief change at the 48 car. Race engineer Cliff Daniels will take over as Jimmie Johnson's crew chief, replacing Kevin Meendering. Immediately. I think that's the big news here. This is going to happen immediately. Daniels is a 31-year-old. He's previously worked at teams like Stuart Haas Racing, joined Hendrick Motorsports back in 2014. So he knows the organization. He's a race car driver. He's raced some late models in his day. He was there for the 2016 champion. I think we all knew it's been a rough year for the 48. Are we surprised they're making a change at this point in the season?
No, I'm not surprised. I mean, it's getting down to the time that they're still within shouting distance of getting into the playoffs. Something needed to be done here. And we've all been through this as far as whether you were a crew chief and, yeah, and replaced or got, or you know, went somewhere else. Jeff, we've had different crew chiefs. But there comes a time that you just have to say, this isn't working. We've got to do something different. And Jimmie Johnson, I think, probably voiced his opinion. And this needed to be done sooner than later.
Yeah, they are really difficult decisions because, remember, this is people's livelihood. Yeah. And not only that, they put their heart and soul into it. Even if they're not having success that everybody wants to have, it's not that everybody's not trying. I spoke to Jimmie a little while ago, and he feels terrible for Kevin because he really believes in Kevin. He said Kevin's still going to be at Hendrick Motorsports. You know, they're hoping to offer him something really good for Kevin because he thinks he can benefit the company. But he's also very excited about Cliff. He, you know, Cliff worked at that team, and he said when Cliff came back and started working on this team this year, that he had an energy. He brought this energy and enthusiasm. The whole team got picked up. And you guys know, like, personality matters,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
And clearly, Cliff's personality is such that he can lead people and get people fired up. And that's so important. When you get up in the morning and you do this week after week after week, and especially after not having success, you got to have a spark. You got to have something. You got to have a motivating factor. And Jimmie feels really good about what he can do technically, but also the way he communicates and how he's got everybody picked up. Jimmy's really excited about what they can do.
So to just connect the dots on the timeline, from what I understand, Daniels comes to Hendrick Motorsports, worked with Chad Knaus through the championship year, takes a role within the organization. They call it their systems department with other engineers, but was called back out of the bullpen at Sonoma to join this 48. And I think that's the time you're referencing where they kind of felt the lift, the energy of Daniels. But guys, this is the simple fact about sports. What have you done lately? What have you done for performance? I have been in this frying pan. I went winless with Jeff Gordon, and guess what? Something changed. I got a new driver. It wasn't going to stay that way. And when you look at the points, something had to happen for this 48. Kevin Meendering, I am a huge Kevin Meendering fan. I think he is a bright, bright crew chief, but personalities have to mesh. Jimmie Johnson, I thought, perhaps wanted to be the leader. Maybe that's why they went that direction. I just think that maybe that's not the case. He liked having a leader like Chad. He's looking for another leader of the race team. He has every right to get the crew chief he wants.
Yeah.
At his age, at his resume, he deserves it. And when you look right here, Jimmie Johnson is not in the top 16 of points. I don't know how to say that. There's no way anyone sitting here predicted Jimmie Johnson may not make the playoffs.
Well, look who's 12th, William Byron. So William Byron, you know, he moved along with Chad Knaus. And William Byron has been outrunning the 48 lately. And, you know, seven-time champion. I'm sorry, William Byron should not be outrunning the seven-time champion. So, you know, Jimmie Johnson has been the most important part of Hendrick Motorsports over the last 7-8 years, is that fair to say?
Oh, yeah, yes.
And so when he's not, maybe longer, if he's not able to win and he's not able to be in the playoffs, something has to change. We talk about Chevrolet's problems. It's really, in my mind, a Hendrick Motorsports problem. Hendrick Motorsports is what makes the Chevrolet program look so good. And when you have Jimmie Johnson, a seven-time champion, that not leading laps. I mean, not doing the things we're expecting to see. Something had to change. There's no way around it.
Well, Rick Hendrick gave his opinion on the change. You know, the big thing is, you see right here, great confidence in Cliff, and which is, you know, of course he does. He made the decision. Ultimately, Rick Hendrick makes the decision there. There's a lot of people that advise him. But, Dale, I think what really turned the pressure up on this 48 is when the organization improved. And what I mean, at the beginning of the year, you could say it was a Hendrick problem, it was a Chevy problem. All right, Chase wins, but that's at Talladega. We can look at that as the anomaly. But then all of a sudden, Alex Bowman's on fire. Second, breakthrough win. Chase Elliott, I know he's had some tough luck, but I don't think we question that combination. They're kind of working through some things. And I think you mentioned the 24. While they haven't won, they're climbing in the points. In my mind, that put a glaring spotlight on the 48.
Yeah, there's no doubt. And, you know, when you sit down as an organization and you have a seven-time champ and you're talking to him about having a new crew chief for the first time in his Cup career, you know, all you can do is try to put the best person that you think that's within your organization or within your grasp in that position. And Kevin Meendering is an excellent person as far as knowing this sport, the in and out. But Jimmie has always had the leadership of Chad Knaus, which is very high strung and very forceful. And Jimmie has made, they made that work. We all shook our heads at times wondering, why are these two even staying together? Well, that's they right. stayed together because they won 80 some races and seven championships. Right. But you had to question that. But this has to be that type of thing. Not saying that Cliff has to go be that, but I think that, that Jimmie is looking for somebody with higher energy. And sometimes you just have to make that change. Plus, now we've got another former driver in this type of situation, along with Rodney Childress and Paul Wolf, that are very successful at what they do.
You know, the question that, that begs to be asked, though, no crew chief experience. Does that surprise anyone, right? I mean, I was fortunate enough that Jeff Gordon said, hey, you're going to be my guy. I went and did the best I could. We had success. But are we surprised that it's not? They have a lot of people over there with crew chief experience. I can go through the Kenny Francis over there. Keith Rodden's over there. Darren Grubbs over there. There's a lot of experienced crew chiefs. Why do you think they go with a young up-and-coming?
I have no problem with it because in today's world, you know, they are hiring him to be able to take the resources that Hendrick Motorsports has and get it all together for that team, right? So from an engineering standpoint, he understands the engineering side of things. Rick Hendrick just talked about he being the spark that the team needed. Jimmie Johnson talking about he had this energy about him. So they feel like technically he's good enough, and then also he has the right personality. To me, the bigger question, right? To me, the bigger question is this. At 31 years old, are you going to stand up to seven-time?
Yeah.
And, you know, demand of seven-time, because he doesn't mind it, right? Jimmie Johnson's a special person. He is so driven, but he doesn't mind you driving him either. He doesn't mind being pushed. So at 31, are you going to be able to stand up and say, look, Jimmie, this is what we got to do, right? And because I think Jimmie will accept it. Jimmie's the kind of guy that doesn't mind that. But that's hard to do. I never won seven championships. I never won one. But even when I was an older driver, crew chiefs wouldn't stand up to me.
Yeah.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
And that was the wrong thing to do. We would have been way better off for a crew chief to say, no, we're not doing it like that. We're doing it like this. And we would have been way better off to do that.
Yeah, I was in that situation, too. I laughed about Jimmie and Chad. But Todd Parrott was a lot like that. I appreciated that. But I could go back at him, and he could come back at me. And you have to have that. And Cliff is going to have to do that if this is going to work. I have no problem that he hasn't been a crew chief. I don't care what his age is. He knows a lot about this sport. And because the crew chief role, if this was late 1990s and early 2000s before the engineering side of it took over so much, then you might have a little bit more of a problem. But not in this case. I think that the biggest part is, Jeff, that you bring up, is he willing to stand up to Jimmie Johnson? Jimmie knows a lot about what takes place over there, the changes of the cars and everything. So he has to be willing to stand up to Jimmie and say, this is the right thing for us. You get the job done because we know what you can do behind the wheel.
Well, my advice will be to do it your way. I've had this opportunity before. Not every decision that I made was correct, but I always felt better win or lose when I did it my own day. And Cliff, good luck, because you're heading to Watkins Glen. And if Pocono's any sign, the pit strategy at Watkins Glen could be complicated. Hey, motorsports fans, thanks for watching. Make sure you hit subscribe before you go for all the latest news and highlights across motorsports.